So this afternoon I've come up to my local fell here in the Lake District just to try and compose a little scene what I identified on a walk during the middle of the day. I went to shoot it with my big camera actually on that day, but my battery ran out as soon as I pressed the shutter, so that was a bit of a nuisance. But anyway, I made the photograph on my mobile phone, which I'll show you now, and I vowed to come back and capture that in more atmospheric conditions, should we say. And that day is today. So it's about 3 o'clock in the afternoon on a Saturday afternoon, and there's been low claggy cloud all day. It's very wet and miserable really, but perfect for this image, and quite remarkable really how you know, you think you have to get up at the crack of dawn to get nice misty atmospheric conditions, but not so. So yeah, I've just been taking a few compositions. I mean, I've walked up here about 3 or 4 times in the middle of the day, and obviously you can see this nice silver birch tree behind me there, and there's a few other sporadic trees just dotted around, if you will. But they really come to life when there's some mist and low cloud, and you get a bit of separation between it and the background, if you will. There's a particular there's a stream which you should be able to hear behind me, which runs down this broken dry stone wall, which I've been composing various scenes from there, and I think that's quite appealing. So you've got like a bank of this rustic bracken in the background, if you will, and then you've got the stream in the center, and then the wall at either side. So I've composed a few images from there. They're quite interesting. Obviously with the trees on in the distance there, which are all in the mist, and then we've got the just a blank canvas of a background. So it's quite interesting. It brings out the shape of the foreground elements, and I've been enjoying spending 10 minutes, 20 minutes just thinking about it really, and looking to see what I can do. So I'll just go continue to have a look around, and we'll see if I can get into any specific, if I get into any nice locations what I feel are worth discussing. I'll see you again in this video. So yes, just I've got my one camera, one lens set up. I've got my little 45mm there under my lens cloth, keeping it nice and dry. I do fancy this tree here, which is the silver birch on the bank there, but it's I just wish it wasn't as close to the one next to it. And there's another one up here as well, but that's lost a lot of its leaves now. But yeah, it's fantastic. It's this section of larch trees just probably further down in the mist what really interests me. It's quite a nice scene. I'll move myself into a better position, and I'll talk to you again in a sec. Okay, so this is the little scene I was mentioning about a moment ago. It's fascinating. Obviously, we've got the wall down my right hand side, the line of ferns down the centre, and then this little boggy stream area, if you will, and then the bank of ferns on the side. These series of trees running down the bank are quite nice. I'm going to try and position myself so I can get some separation between these two trees here in the direct foreground, but the trees certainly down the hill are looking quite interesting, where they're all mixed in amongst the fog there. So that's quite appealing. So I'm just going to have a little wander down this next 10 or 20 metres of the path, if you will, or the wall, and see if I can arrange these elements in a photogenic manner. I've taken a quick shot there, which I'll show you now, but I'd like to try and spend 5 or 10 minutes just trying to, you know, make sure I've definitely got the best composition there is out there. So we'll go for that. Okay, so I think I've found the best composition I'm going to get with this lens. I'm using a 45mm lens here, which is equivalent to around 35mm in 35mm format. And I'm finding from this particular low angle I've got here, where I want to capture the ferns here, my lens just isn't quite wide enough to get both trees and provide enough separation. You need to be a bit further back and obviously zoom out a bit. Now, the way I zoom in and out is with my feet, because I just use prime lenses, so I can't really you know, getting a specific vantage point and then zooming in and out. So, and by the time I've not, I've moved back, if you will, I lose the foreground interest of the ferns there. So that's a bit of a shame, but quite happy with what I've captured there. It's I'm neglecting this tree on the left and just focusing on this one in the centre, and then obviously the larch tree and the oak tree down at the bottom, which I think it's going to work. You've got the bank of ferns. I haven't got the wall in this shot, and I would like to get the wall in, so I'm going to have to work a bit harder to try and find a specific viewpoint where I've got the line of ferns, the line of the wall, and also the line of the ferns on the other side of the bank as well. I think those three lines leading us into the image with the trees across, and then the mist in the background silhouetting those two trees, could work quite well. That's the theory anyway, that's the thoughts going through my mind. Whether or not it's physically possible is another matter, but I'm going to try and look for that, and that's what I'm going to spend the next few minutes doing. So just quickly, whilst I'm manoeuvring myself around this little area, I noticed I've got the four trees up on the bank opposite me there. I do like these two trees. Like I say, I wish the birch was on its own. But what I've done is I've just tried to hide this tree on the left behind this wall, and I couldn't really achieve that, to be honest. But what I did notice is that I can use the edge of this wall just to add a little bit of foreground interest on the left-hand side of the frame. So I've composed that, and I've just shot it now. So I'll put that up and you can see what you think of that. But it's, I think what happens is I get in the zone of looking, you know, I've been massively or acutely visually aware of all these little things, and you're just moving, and every time, oh, there's a shot. And it's quite enjoyable. I find that quite enjoyable. Whether it works or not is another thing, but it inspired me to compose it and take the button. So that's great. And take the pictures, so that's fascinating. This wall's quite nice as well as it comes down the fell side. I'll just show you that, and you can see there with the trees up in the top right hand corner where we've got the mist. It's just a bit of mist really brings it out. Again, looking downstream there, we've got our two trees in the foreground with the down the ravine, if you will. So yeah, I'm going to see if I can, still working on this, see if I can get something, but we'll see how it goes. So I've decided to walk up the hill a little bit and come to the top of the wall so I can walk down the length of it along the little well, it's not really a path, but the clearing, if you will, just to see how it's, you know, where I could be to compose it. And just like that, the mist seems to have, or the cloud seems to have lifted, so you can probably see down there, you can see buildings down there now, which a few seconds ago were shrouded in mist. So it's and the scene's just totally lost its mystique, if you will. It's kind of lost its atmospheric look. It's really amazing how in just a matter of seconds it's just blown away and change the whole look of the scene. So I think I'm going to stick it out for a few minutes, because I think it could well come back. I mean, you can see down, I don't know if you'll see it there, but you can see it blowing around the mist, and you can see the mist blowing down there. And if I just pan to the right a little bit, you can see what's going on. So I'm not sure if it's going to stay like that or if it's going to come back. So I'm going to stick it out. I'll walk up and down the ferns anyway, and I'll try and identify the location I want to shoot from and compose it with my lens, and I'll wait it out and see if it comes back. But if not, then I've already had a few interesting shots, so my luck might have run out for today. Okay, so I've given up on the composition further up the hill there. I just don't think I'm going to be able to compose what my mind can see, if you will. The concept of it sounds great, but the reality is I just can't compose it. So because of my focal length, also because of the gradient of the hill by the time you've moved down, various things don't line up. So just one of those things, you know, it's, I guess you've got to have a bit of an imagination to see these things and to find something. What I have done though is come further down the hill here. I'm stood right by the stream now, and you can obviously see the mists cleared out there in the background. But this particular scene where I've got the wall in there, you can have a look here, you've got the wall in my direct foreground there, and then the bank coming down and the larch trees in the distance on the left with the oak tree just down below. That I should have come down here 5-10 minutes ago, to be honest. I think I should have come down here earlier, because this is probably the best shot from here, in my opinion. I mean, if that was all covered out in the mist, I think that would have made a really atmospheric shot. But what we can see in the background, just to the left of the larch tree, is just the top of a fell appearing out. So I'm going to take this again, and hopefully that'll give me some elements in the distance what I can work with to add a dynamic element to this shot. Okay, and so I've just come down to this very bottom tip now where the stream meets the wall. I can't really go any further without losing the wall or walking through the middle of the stream. And I think this is probably my nicest view, or the nicest composition I've framed up there this afternoon. It's quite nice with this. Obviously, we've got a bit of a fallen down wall here. You get a really prominent view of the wall in the foreground going down into the stream. Now, I'm not sure how much of the stream will be visible in the shot, but it's certainly there, as you'll hear. And I think what attracts me to it is you've got three things going on in the foreground. Let me just show you here. So we've got the line of the wall, we've got the line of the ferns, and then you've got this green and brown, the grass, and obviously the other grasses there. And then you've also then got the two lines at either side. What are drawing is down to that central point, and right in that central point we've got a collection of trees. Now, it's funny because prior to walking down here I was really satisfied with how this shoot's going, and now I'm thinking I need to come back here again when it's misty to get this exact composition, when the same mist I've had 10-15 minutes ago is there, because that would make for a beautiful scene, I think. It's quite surprising, but this is why, you know, when you look at my vlogs, I show you the entire process. I don't just show you 8 minutes of getting to a location and then taking one shot, because that's not, to me, that's not real landscape photography. Real landscape photography is immersing yourself within one specific location and experimenting with shots, and it's usually the shots at the end of the shoot which are the richest or the best shots, if you will. That is in my particular case, you know, and I think that's a real transparent, honest view of how I take my landscape photographs. And it's not made for like entertainment from a vlog's perspective. It's made as a real life documentation of how I, as a professional landscape photographer, go on and make my shots. So if anything, I want it to be genuine and honest as a way of showing how the shots unfold, because every shot you see has got a story behind it. And this shot you've just seen there, the story is the last 5 or 10-15 minutes, whatever it's going to be, to get to it. Anyway, what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to have a wander about. I'm probably going to wrap the video up there for now. So thanks again for joining me on the channel. It's much appreciated, your continued support. I'm continuing to experiment with how I make my vlogs, and this is a new style again altogether. And we'll see how we go with it. It's quite an interesting medium, making a video and making a vlog. It's quite interesting, quite the challenge, which I'm finding quite interesting. So hopefully I'll be getting there to a format what suits everybody. Okay, thanks for watching. I'll catch you again on the next video, hopefully coming soon. All the best for now. See you soon. Bye-bye. Okay, so this image is an attempt for me to recreate the image I took on my previous walk up here during the day. As it turned out, I didn't manage to find the exact location from the original shot. Well, not when the mist was present anyway. But what I have found here is quite an interesting composition, I think, with the, I think it's a hawthorn tree on the right, and the large oak tree, which is behind the bank on the left. And then we've got our larch trees in the on the horizon, if you will, or on the ridge of the fell there. So I find that quite an appealing shot there with the mist in the background. So for this particular image, it's again a take on the original image with the larch trees on the ridge line going down the fell side there. And what I chose to do with this particular image is I've cropped it into a square crop to give emphasis to the large oak tree in the foreground. And I positioned myself carefully so that I would get the dry stone wall leading us in from the left hand side to the base of the oak tree. What you might notice in this image is there are some branches encroaching onto the left hand side of the scene. That's one of the reasons why I cropped it into a square. But I still think it works quite well, and you've got some very faint outlines or silhouettes of trees on the right hand side as well. So overall, quite a pleasing image. I'm often thinking of landscape painters when I make images like this, and you see paintings in galleries sometimes, what, you know, they're nothing spectacular or dramatic in lighting, but they seem to work, and I think this has that feel for me. So this is an image what I've tried to carefully compose with the five trees on the fell side there. We've got the large silver birch still in bloom, if you will, in its autumn colours in the top right hand corner, and then another silver birch in the second from the left, and then the three other trees, which are all different shapes really, and I think it works quite well. We've got a bit of a path, well, I think that's the stream what's running diagonally through the lower third of the image, and then obviously a little bit of a path leading us into that where you can see the green grass. And again, I feel it's got some elements to it what work, where the initial path what leads us in on the green, and then we've got our diagonal path on the left, and it just picks up another clearing through the ferns on the very left hand side of the frame. So again, with the addition of the mist, it really makes quite an atmospheric shot, but I'm quite pleased with that. I think it's as a composition, I feel it's got potential. Whether it's worked in this case or not is up for debate, but I'm quite pleased with how that's turned out. Okay, so moving down to the bottom of the stream there, where the path and the stream and the wall all converge with the bank of the ferns on the left. I'm really glad I persevered with this location and had a look around further down the stretch of the river, if you will. I think it just got better and better, did the composition, as I explored further into it. Like I say, the original intention was to capture the larch trees, which you can see on the left hand side very faintly silhouetted in the mist, and we've got our large oak tree on the right, which is what featured in an earlier image I reviewed. I think the addition of the broken wall really adds to it, where you can see there you've got your semicircle hole in the wall, which I positioned, I don't think I did it intentionally at the time, but just being below the oak tree, it seems to work for me, and I like to include a lot of foreground wherever possible as well. So I got down a bit lower with this composition and made the ferns and the bracken a prominent feature in the foreground, if you will. But again, I think it works. There's a lot of lines coming together to meet in that central point where we've got our trees. And yeah, I'm quite pleased with how that's turned out. So this is a slight variation on the previous composition. I just got a bit lower to the ground and focused more on the green fern in the bottom left hand corner, if you can see that there. It's a lovely fern, actually. It's just in its transition between its green and going to yellow and then into the browns before it dies off. But again, I think there's a number of lines in this picture which you've obviously got your fern there, bottom left corner, and you've got two prominent lines in the foreground. There's a line just to the right of the fern, what leads us down into the wall and the brown reeds, if you will, what are around the stream. And then we've got the line what forms part of the where the reeds meet the grass. And then it, above that, in the middle of the frame, we've got the line of the bottom of the wall, the top of the wall, the green bank diagonally coming down. And on the left-hand side, we've got the bank of the fern. So we've got the bottom of the ferns, the top of the ferns, and then above that, we've got the edge of the fell, if you will. And all those lines converge into a central point where the trees then grow out of. And I find that quite interesting. And on the right-hand side, we've got the oak tree, which is obviously a deciduous tree, and it's losing its leaves. And then we've got the larch trees on the left, which are different species, if you will. And I just kind of like that that symmetry down the middle, where we've got our dry stone wall on the right, and then we've got our ferns on the left, and it kind of mirrors itself through the image. But yeah, I don't know if I'm looking at that too deeply, but there is something quite appealing about that image to me. So this is about midway down the bank of the wall and the ferns. And this is where I was struggling to piece together the composition, if you will. I think ideally what I wanted was a gap between these two trees on the left-hand side. I wanted them both to stand on their own. They're quite nicely shaped trees, and I would have liked to have used the mist to add the atmosphere, but to have the separation, if you will, between the two trees so you can see them individually. But as I was saying in the video, as you move down the bank, my lens just isn't wide enough to be able to zoom out to be able to capture that. And if I move backwards and forwards, it doesn't seem to I crop something out. So the main construction of this image really is that bank of ferns just running down the edge of the reedy stream there, and you've got the lighter tone of grass, and then the darker tone of grass where it's all boggy there, and then that picks up with the wall coming in and the green bank going up, and we've got our oak tree at the bottom there, and then going back up the other way, we've got our bank of ferns with our two trees growing out of that, and then another diagonal line coming in for the silhouetted edge of the fell. And with the mist, it's just a really strong image, that one. I do really like that. And it's an image I would never have pre-visualized prior. You know, I went to shoot the original mobile phone image, really, and just by spending, you know, 15-20 minutes looking, it's amazing what comes out, especially when the mist is on your side to add a bit of separation. But yeah, I'm very pleased with that image. I think I've constructed that pretty well, and I think it works. I find it really appealing. Okay, so this image is a distraction, really, and it's, if I hadn't have taken this image, I would have probably managed to get the mist the mist went just after I took this image, so I would have probably got the mist further down the stream. But I think there's some merit to this picture in its own right. Obviously, in a previous picture, we saw the five trees on the fell side there, and I've just isolated two of them here. I think I said in the video that it would have been nice just to have the silver birch on the right on its own. And I did try and compose that with moving my camera to the left to try and crop off the tree on the left-hand side, but it just left the tree up too close to the edge of the frame, and it didn't really work. So I used this bit of a dry stone wall to add some interest on the left-hand side, and then we've got our bank of ferns going up into the mist there, and our two trees. So overall, I'm not overly sure how successful that image is, but you know, you've got to try these things when you're outside, and you never know, it might work. I think I mentioned in the film as well about how I become heightened or acutely visually aware when I'm starting to shoot, and that was a good example of this shoot, because you go with no real expectations with the wider scene, but as you warm up into the shoot, so to speak, a lot of things jump out, and that's no different here. And it was actually a very rewarding shoot for me. I thoroughly enjoyed every minute of it. So here's a square crop, just looking over the entire scene, really. So this is if you like an environmental shot of the path I was walking up and down, the wall I was walking up and down to try and make the images work. And this is probably one of the only shots I've got where I did find the separation between the two trees on the left. I think it works. I think it works quite nicely. It's obviously we've got a bit of a dry stone wall in the left hand side, what pulls us down, and then we can pick up a faint line of the bank of the ferns just continuing the diagonal trend through the image, and then we've got more towards us, we've got another bank of ferns there. So there is sections to this image. We've got the grassy kind of hemisphere in the foreground, the wall, the bank of ferns, the line of the stream, if you will, and then the two trees, and then the larch and the oak in the background. And the the diagonal lines of the silhouette of the fells really does help to pull my eye into it's kind of that dip in the bottom right corner of the scene where all the trees converge. Everything seems to be pulling us to that point. So yeah, I mean this image as well, it might have been a successful image if I'd have caught this as the mist was just lifting up a little bit, and we had have seen some of the maybe the trees or the buildings or the fells in the very foreground in the valley bottom, if that might have just added a bit more mysterious elements to that image. It would have given it a bit more depth perhaps. But there we go, I'm pleased with that image. I think maybe in hindsight, reviewing it now, perhaps I could have got a bit lower to maybe bring the top of the near tree on the left hand side, so the top of its branches did poke through and puncture that line, if you will, of the fells there, like it does in the one next to it. But overall, I'm pretty pleased with that. I think it's a pretty successful image for me. So this is one of the final images I made when the mist had started to lift up from the valley bottom below. There was a lot more clarity in the scene with regards to the trees and the elements I was trying to compose. But I think as the shoot went on, the images got stronger and stronger for me, compositionally, but maybe not environmentally. And what I mean by that is, I think as I got closer to the edge of the little path or the stream and where the wall all converged there with the bank of ferns, all these lines, what you can see in that image, really helped to make it a more interesting image in my opinion. So again, if you take the concept of lines, where we've got the diagonals of the fells coming down into the central area where the trees are, and then away from that we've got the diagonal of the wall and the diagonal of the reeds, there's something about that image what I find really appealing. It is just a shame that I left it a bit late to find that. I think with a bit more mist around the larch trees and the oak tree in the distance, it would have perhaps made it a bit more of an atmospheric shot. And I think as well, because the fell side on the left is now a lot clearer than it was in previous images, it's lost a bit of atmosphere. But I still think it's a strong composition. I just think it could probably be improved by having a bit more mist in the immediate foreground as opposed to just in the distance. I do think as well, as I mentioned in a previous image where we've got through and we can see the valley bottom through there, that does add some depth to the image. So it's not just a swamp of mist, if you will. There is some distance to it, and I quite like that element as well. But it would have been nice just to have had a little bit of cloud or mist just clinging to the fell side to diffuse that portion of the image. But overall, I'm pleased with that. Okay, so this is a landscape orientation take on the previous image, and again, all the same points are relevant with regards to the environment, the mist, the cloud, and the composition as well. I think this one's maybe a little bit of a stronger composition in the sense that we've got this darker line, if you will, between on the left-hand side between the reeds, the grass and the ferns, and that line seems to continue over the wall and up the green bank right through the image. So it cuts the image in half, and then if you then tip up to like 45 degrees from the top left corner, we've got the line of the fell coming down, and then it picks up with pretty much the line of the wall, the dry stone wall there, where we've got our semicircular hole with the stones what have fallen off there. I think if in hindsight, just reviewing that again,
it might have been a better image if I'd have just got a bit lower. So if you was to draw a diagonal line from the top left corner going down the fell side, if I would have perfectly picked up that dry stone wall. But on reviewing it again now, I think if that hole wasn't in the wall, I probably have done that, more or less. But you can overthink these things, you know, in the moment when you stood there. You can't always think of every minute detail, but this is why I think it's important to review your images afterwards, or it is for me anyway, and see what comes of it there. So yeah, another strong image, I feel. It's just perhaps would benefit from a little bit more mist, but like I say, you can see into the distance on the fell side now, and it's yeah, quite atmospheric. I'm pleased with that. Okay, so this is my final image of the shoot, where I get really close to the fallen down section of the wall. And again, following on from the previous images I've reviewed here with regards to my comments about the mist and how that's now left and the diagonal lines, I think compositionally this is a very strong image. I think just touching upon my point about the diagonal from top left to bottom right, where the fell side meets the wall, I think this is probably a more successful image, where we've got, if you follow the line down from the top left corner, it does meet into the wall, and then it obviously curves around where the wall has fallen down. So I think there's some continuity there. And again, on the left, on the right hand side, following the green bank down, that does meet the wall, which then continues into the reeds at the bottom. So again, there's a lot of lines, there's a lot of things for your eye to follow. What really appealed to me about this scene was the fallen down stones. And to me, that this is almost, it's like a watercolour or an oil. It's a painting, what you would see in a gallery window. You know, you see quite a lot of these Lakeland scenes where they're not massive vistas, they're not popular views, they're just little shots within a scene in the countryside. They could be anywhere, really, but there is a few strong composition elements what pull it all together. And for me, I think I've managed to achieve that here. I think I could look at that for quite a while, and it's quite appealing. I think maybe I could process it a little differently and make it a bit more pastely and a bit softer, but overall I'm pleased with that. And I think like I say, the shoot developed and the better images came out close to the end of it, so it was well worth sticking around and well worth looking at the work in the scene, if you will.